So hello everybody. So welcome to this conference, Integrating Evolutionary Genetics and Ecology. So first I would like to thank the Fondation Jean-François and Marie-Laure de Clermont-Tonnerre for their financial support, and also Collège de France for welcoming me at this annual share Biodiversity and Ecosystems for this year. And I also would like to thank Institut Jacques Monod, Université de Paris, and Institut de Génétique Fonctionnelle de Lyon, IGFL, for their financial support. So this conference aims to bring together researchers working at the intersection between evolutionary genetics and ecology to study the evolution of animals and plants. And ecology and evolutionary biology are two different disciplines in biology. Evolutionary biology focuses on the processes and the mechanisms underlying evolution of living beings, whereas ecology focuses on the interactions between organisms and their environment, studying how organisms interact with each other and with their physical surroundings. Nevertheless, both disciplines are closely intertwined. Evolutionary processes shape the traits and the characteristics of organisms, influencing their ecological interactions, while ecological interactions provide the selective pressures that drive evolutionary change. Consequently, a comprehensive understanding of organisms and their environment often requires an integration of both ecological and evolutionary perspectives. So in these two disciplines, timescales have generally been quite different. Evolutionary biology operates on longer timescales, often spanning thousands of to millions of years, whereas ecological studies generally focus on short timescales, ranging from days to years. Ecological studies investigate the immediate response of organisms to their environment and how these interactions influence population dynamics and community composition. But in recent years, research has shown that evolution can be very fast and can occur within a few generations. Both disciplines involve a significant part of field observations and modeling. And the spatial scale is also different, with ecological studies often being done at the level of the individual, the population, or the communities, while evolutionary biology considers species or larger taxonomic groups. But some very important evolutionary studies are also done at the level of populations, thus bridging the gap between evolutionary biology and ecology. Evolutionary biology focuses on and puts emphasis on genetic change, whereas ecology emphasizes the interdependency and interactions between organisms and their environment. And nowadays, there is increasing recognition that ecological and evolutionary genetics approaches should be combined to study phenotypic diversity, adaptation, and evolution. So I hope that this conference can lead to the establishment of new collaborative links between researchers from these two disciplines. So I'm very happy to welcome all the speakers of today's session and tomorrow's session on this topic. And so the first day is here, but the second day of the meeting will be at Institut Jacques Monod in the 13th arrondissement, and you are all welcome to join. So if you haven't registered for the second day, you can come and I can put you on the list. And so thank you for coming, and I hope you will enjoy the conference. Yeah.